Hey, good early morning, 426 Wilkes-Barre, PA. Very overcast and cloudy. Big thunderstorms rolled through. Let's see, Motel 6. I strongly advise against it, unless you're absolutely dead broke. We have those women that are working, to put it politely. And we had barking dogs all night. And there were people doing donuts in the parking lot and not Dunkin' Donuts. So yeah, I am not too sure about Wilkes-Barre, PA, the location I stayed. It was a joke, to say the least. Oh, it's 73 degrees. And this morning I was smart. I put my I put a sweatshirt on underneath my coat, because yesterday morning I was cold for the first 2 hours. Not cold, but chilled. Well, we'll find our way out to the interstate. We'll take 81 north to up into New York, and we'll take 81 north up towards New York, and we'll get on Interstate 88, and we'll head over towards Albany, and then we'll head into Vermont. I had camera woes yesterday. I recorded a lot of content. All my video clips, all 14 of them, played on the camera, but I couldn't load them onto the PC, just audio. I don't know, it was very weird. I'm sorry about the loud noises, but I need that face shield open so I can see, so I don't fog up. I really need to get a pin lock. For those of you who know what a pin lock is, it's a thin plastic shield that goes against your inside of your face shield, and it prevents fogging. So that's that. I changed up my music choice for the day so far. Right now I'm listening to Golden Oldies. You can only listen to so much hard rock and heavy metal throughout the course of a trip. Oh boy, fogging bad. Once again, sorry about the wind noise, but it is what it is. Alright, well, I won't bore you. 72 degrees. Very dark, big thunderstorms, donut makers in the parking lot, ladies that work at night, and very little sleep. So if Motel 6 is on your list of places to stay, make sure you're either into drugs, donuts, or women that work at night. All right. Stay tuned, see what other shenanigans can happen today. Hey, welcome back to a small slice of America. And hey, before I forget again, give me a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Google Maps just said daybreak. Garmin says I have a state line coming up in 2 miles. It's giving me the motorcycle helmet warning, saying, yeah, helmets are most likely mandatory, along with an ironclad suit, seeing where we're going into New York. Although it will be upstate New York, and that is much different than where all the laws are made, if you follow me. So I will be we'll be going into, well, biker-friendly neighborhood, biker-friendly state, but not so much any other thing friendly. So, yeah, once I get on Interstate 88 and start heading west over towards Albany and Vermont, I'm going to find some place to stop and have some breakfast. It is super gray. I mean, this is, I say my prayers and keeping my fingers crossed for no precipitation. I was thinking of turning the camera on. There was a, I was in the mix with about, oh geez, I want to say at least 50 to 60 tractor trailer trucks just twisting it way up this up and down these mountains. It was pretty insane for a solid 35 minutes. I was like, what am I doing? But you gotta go. You gotta go or you gotta get run over. I keep saying that. You can't go slow on the interstates and hold these guys up or anybody up. You gotta go. If you're gonna get out here, you gotta mix it up with them. Hold your line. Let yourself be visible. Don't get in their blind spots. Make sure you can see yourself in their mirrors. If you can do that, then you're all set. Yeah, I don't know if you caught the glimpse of that choo-choo train on a trailer truck, but it was there. Yeah, now the construction vehicles are gonna start coming out. Air quality alert, limit outdoor activity. That's nice. That's not good for somebody like me with COPD. Nice. Thank you, Canada. Oh, so, I did not see a sign for New York to welcome me. Well, Binghamton is 9, Syracuse is 78. Southern Tier Welcome Center, 1 mile, so we're about a mile away. So if you want to sit tight and help me welcome in New York, what YouTuber can I rip off today? No, I'm only kidding, fellow YouTubers. Only kidding. I should limit my talking, because the more I talk, the more I fog up my face shield. There's the Southern Tier Welcome Center, so we should be in New York. I don't see the sign. Interesting. I love New York on the thingamajig. Stay up the truck's butt that all that long. Interesting. No real big sign. All right. Well, I guess it's an uneventful welcome to New York. Whoop-de-doo. Okay. Thanks for hanging out. Oh wait, I see a blue sign up here. Maybe that's it. Nope, too small. No really big sign. There was just that little emblem in the berm for the rest area. So. What can one do? Alright.
All right, so made it over to Interstate 88. We are eastbound now and heading towards Albany, New York. From Albany, I'm gonna jump on, I gotta do a couple real quick switches, 87 to 90 or 90 to 87. And then I'm gonna get off and I'm gonna get on, I think it is Route 7 in New York. And that'll bring me into Vermont 9. And then I think that's where I trade the spider in on a jet ski to get across Vermont and New Hampshire. No, as I said in the other video that's yet to be posted, camera woes. Don't mean anything disrespectful towards you Vermonters. I know you guys are struggling big time now. I feel for you. You know, down in Florida, we got hurricanes. We got our own issues with flooding and drought and everything else. So, my heart goes out to all you Vermonters and everything you're dealing with. It's terrible. Anyways, this countryside here in New York is absolutely beautiful. I don't know if the camera's picking it up, but the sun is turning the fog pink. So I got pink fog. Interesting. I just wonder if the camera can pick that up. It's calling for thunderstorms and scattered whatever nonsense today. We'll see. I have 4 hours and, that one there is longer because it's going to Concord. This one here is shorter because it's going to my sister's house. So there's a 47-minute difference between the two, and that's okay. So I got 4 hours and 20 minutes to my sister's. I did make my hotel reservation just to be safe. Oh, boy, hotels in New Hampshire are expensive. Wow, that was a little shock. Geez, two nights gonna cost me $500. Blah. And that was the cheapest hotel. All right, I'm not gonna bore you people. I'm on the hunt for some breakfast. Oh, I gotta bring you people in for that. Isn't that gorgeous? That's pretty amazing. All right. So I am fed. I stopped at a Denny's that didn't open till 7 a.m., but the sign said 24 hours. So, according to the waitress, still suffering the lingering effects of COVID. Nice. This Interstate 88, boy, there is some beautiful scenery along here. If you ever put this on your bucket list if you ever want to drive an absolutely gorgeous interstate. There are some beautiful mountain vista views and valleys and hills and dales. It's incredible. I have another motorcyclist creeping up on me. First other bike I've seen today. Looks like some kind of sport bike from the position the rider is in. But I could be wrong. So, it has gotten hazy. They have signs out here on the interstate saying there's an air quality alert, and I believe them because you can taste it. You can taste the smoke. Very weird. Very weird. Mr. Sport Bike Rider is going to go by me. I believe that was a 48. That's what they call that. Yeah, that was a, that's a Harley 48, a retro model. My son, my late son Patrick had one of those. Yes, he did. Now I can see why he owned it. Nice looking bike. All right, that's that. All right, people, we are about to go into Vermont. So that'll be another state down. How many that is, I don't know. But anywho, geez, coming out of that New York 7, that was incredible. Twisty, turny, and wish I didn't have an obstruction of a tractor trailer truck and a slow moving camper in front of me, because they were going like 15 and under the speed limit. Well, we should be entering Vermont momentarily. In a minute. Words. I'm having a tough time with them. And there we are. There is the sign right there. Welcome to Vermont, wee-hee, Green Mountain State. I'll say one thing about Vermont, it is green, and they have great coffee. Green Mountain coffee is excellent. I wish we could have it in Florida, but I guess I could always buy it online, but then you're paying more for it. All right, I'll be checking in periodically. Oh, thumbs up, subscribe, all that. Thank you. Thank you. All right, I think I'm going to be turning into New Hampshire once I get off this exit. And we will have knocked off another state. So anybody keep a count, because too tired to count. And once we cross over the White River, I believe it's the White River or it's the Connecticut River, I can't remember which, we'll be in New Hampshire. Yeah, that's the way I'm going down that way. Oh, nice. I like these bridges. New bridge, same as the old bridge. Just the way it should be. Oh, and that said, welcome to New Hampshire, in a little tiny slit there. So here's the official sign right up here. Welcome, bienvenue to New Hampshire. Whee! All right. Be going to my sister's house momentarily. Thank you. I have reached the 3 bars of death. This here is Daring, New Hampshire. Is it Daring? New Daring, New Hampshire? I don't know. Whatever. It's been a long ride. I think I've already cracked the 2,000 mile mark. I know I have to go by the Oxbow Campground before I get to her house. It looks like I just missed the thunder mustache shower. Lucky me. Huh? Alright, there's the Oxbow Campground. And she should be the next driveway. There she is. My sister's neighbors right here on the right, her neighbors, those people will bore you to death. Alrighty, we are here. It has been a long ass ride, but we made it. Thank you for hanging out. Thumbs up, subscribe, blah, blah, blah.